In this episode, we'll be finding out what happens throughout lambing season, starting to understand what jobs have to be completed to enable lambing time to run smoothly and effectively. But first, let's meet the owners. Meet Richard and Liz Rabjohns, the owners of the farm, and their sons, Harry and Ollie. These guys overlook the process of the season. Let's meet the rest of the family. Meet Kim and Flame, the two working collies who help bring the sheep in and out of the fields. Lottie the Labrador, she's the family household pet. And finally, Molly, she's a sprocker and being trained to be a gun dog during the shooting season. The stage is started off with these two rams. Yes, meet Justin and Julian. These fellows are put into a field with a bunch of ewes who are left to be inseminated. A ram harness is placed onto the ram and a coloured crayon is attached to it to let the farmer know who has been served. After 5 months, the ewes are ready to give birth. The ewes are brought into these tunnels by Flay and Kim and are ready to lamb. Before they lamb, they are fed ewe rolls and silage every day. They are checked daily and night shifts are dedicated to check on them during the evening. A lamb is born and is gently helped out of its mother. The mother is left to lick the amniotic fluid off her lambs. The mother and her lambs are brought into a separate pen where she is not disturbed and left to bond with her lambs. Doubles are usually given milk from their mothers to make them stronger. This is known as tubing. Over the next few days, the ewes and the lambs in the pens are regularly looked after in the mornings and the evenings. Being fed cobs and silage, along with fresh straw and water. Once a few days have gone past, the lambs and the ewes are ready to be numbered up. Eonage occurs if the lamb is a ewe lamb, usually from a double, and wanted for breeding. Castration happens if the lamb is a male. Their tails are then castrated. The lamb is then injected with 1 milliliter of Jufamax LA. This is to prevent joint ill. An orf is scratched onto the lamb, and the lamb is then numbered, the same as the ewe. Red is a single, and blue is a double. Iodine is then resprayed onto its navel. Tags can be used to identify different breeds. Once they are numbered, they rest until they are moved out. They are transported into the trailer and taken to different fields depending on how many lambs the ewe has got. Singles are usually separated from doubles. Lambs have coats put on them to make sure they don't get too cold and wet in the bad weather. The lambs and ewes are transported into a field and the ewes are left to find their right lamb. If they can't find the right lamb, this happens. Once the ewes and lambs have left their pens, it's time to clear up, ready for the next lot. They're cleaned up and put into a trailer, which is then taken away.
The hardest part of lambing season is the long hours for not a lot of money at the moment. It's all pretty easy work, but it's difficult when you're tired and working long days. When we're in the middle of lambing, I usually get up at 5 and then do the pens until 7, and then go to my actual job until 6 and then go outside till about 8, 9 o'clock. Yes, very, because whenever you finish, you're always extremely tired and don't want to do anything. You'd want to sell about 150% of what you lamb. Well, he's always had the saying, and he's told all of us, that whenever you stop smiling at lambs, that's the time to retire.
Okay.
I would have thought he'd probably like to be a dairy farmer instead of a sheep farmer, because it's a lot less hard work and a lot less stress sometimes. Yeah, sometimes when it's rewarding, but it's just difficult for him because our family's real hard working, and it's only really him at home a lot of the time. And it's difficult. No. Come on. Up. There she is.
These are tamed lambs. Tamed lambs have to be bottle fed separately. This is because their mother cannot look after them properly, or they have no or not enough milk to feed them. That's all of the stages then within the lambing season. Cheerio!